there for this video, we will be talking about molar mass. So when we say molar mass, the molar mass of a substance is the mass per mole of its entities, meaning the atoms, the molecules, or formula units of the substance. And in determining the molar mass of monoatomic elements, the molar mass of these elements will be the same as the atomic mass, which is indicated in the periodic table of elements. And instead of using atomic mass units as the unit of measurement, we use the grams per mole to express the molar mass of these elements. So for example, we have chlorine. So in the periodic table, the atomic mass of chlorine is 35.45 amu. So now, the molar mass of chlorine is also 35.45 grams per mole. The other example would be barium, which has a molar mass of 137.33 grams per mole. And then for molecular elements or for compounds, the formula or the chemical formula for these compounds are needed to determine the molar mass of the compound. So how do we determine the molar mass of a compound? Say, for example, we have sulfur dioxide. So in order for us to determine the molar mass of sulfur dioxide, we have to identify first the elements involved in the compound. So we have sulfur and oxygen. And then afterwards, we determine how many atoms of each element are in the compound. So there is one atom of sulfur and then there are two atoms of oxygen. Afterwards, we multiply them by their respective molar masses. So sulfur is equivalent to 30.07 grams per mole, while oxygen has a molar mass of 15.999 grams per mole. And then we multiply them, so sulfur we will have 32.07 grams per mole, and in oxygen we will have 31.998 grams per mole. After multiplying these values, we will now add the molar masses of each element. So we have here 64.07 grams per mole, and that would be the molar mass of sulfur dioxide. In another example, we have calcium phosphate. So same steps we will follow. We will have to determine the elements in the compound. We have calcium, phosphorus, and oxygen. And then we determine now how many atoms per element is in the compound. So we have 3 atoms of calcium. And then if we distribute the subscript 2 in the parentheses, we will have 2 atoms of phosphorus and 8 atoms of oxygen. Afterwards, we multiply them by their respective molar masses. So for calcium, we have 40.08 grams per mole. In phosphorus, we have 30.97 grams per mole. And in oxygen, we have 15.999 grams per mole. So for calcium, we will arrive at a total of 120.24 grams per mole. For phosphorus, we have 61.94 grams per mole, while in oxygen, we have 127.992 grams per mole. If we add them all up, we will arrive at the molar mass of calcium phosphate, which is 310.17 grams per mole. And that would be all for this video. Thank you!